Let's now get a reaction from Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship, Joey Concepcion. Good afternoon, sir, and welcome to the program.
Good afternoon.
Mr. Concepcion, you've been very vocal in the possibility and in pushing for a lower alert level to here in the region, but they just decided that they're extending this alert level 3 for 2 more weeks. How much do you think is being lost by, you know, economy-wise and also for businesses, that this easing of restrictions, even more so, didn't happen?
Well, as you know, on August, we closed the lockdown, the early lockdown, 2 weeks early lockdown, and OCTA advised us to do such to be able to protect our fourth quarter. So the IATF at that point in time had a different position. But when they found, when I talked to Secretary Galvez and told him the private sector wants to lock down to save the fourth quarter, he definitely agreed with it, and together with the mayors. No? So if you look at that lockdown, that was business never called for a lockdown. But we did it. No? Now, we saw the cases go up, and as predicted by OCTA, it will drop in October. And it has dropped in October. So that is the difference. Now, we are seeing a downward trend as fast. Now, some people don't believe it, but I believe it because we have achieved almost 85% fully vaccinated in NCR. Now, I believe that NCR deserves an alert level 2. But I also talked to the business organizations when we had that meeting just to expect alert level 3, because I know that the government may put some break, no? It will try to push a bit and not go fast. So everybody is ready to accept alert level 3, but this should not go beyond November 15. Mm-hmm. If alert level 3 will still stay on beyond November 15, then we can forget this fourth quarter. No, we have to increase the business capacity of these establishments because they're trying to recover months of losses. They have a 13 month to pay. They have loans to pay, and they have children to feed. No, so they are really in great trouble.
Mr. Concepcion?
An alternative, we are willing to accept it, and hopefully November 15, we move to alert level 2.
Now, sir, 2 weeks is still 2 weeks. Of course, that's still affecting a lot of businesses. You know, is there a way for the business sector to at least, you know, be able to cushion not being able to ease restrictions and to be able to increase their capacities for their establishments?
Well, the advantage of NCR on top of alert level 3 giving you 30%, since NCR is at 85%, there's a plus 20% and plus a safety seal of 10%, so that's 60%. No? So alert level 2 would have given us 80%, so that's 20% more in capacity. Now, all I'm just saying is that we have to move to alert level 2 no later than November 15, and I think they will do that.
How about, Mr. Concepcion, for the fitness sector? Do you still see them opening up more capacity for gyms, even in alert level 3? And how about for other industries?
Yes, the push is, actually, the gyms are open up to 60% right now because NCR is fully vaccinated up to 85%. So that's the advantage, no? This incentive. So LGUs who are able to vaccinate more and achieve no less than 70% get that plus 20%, no? Now, if you don't achieve that, you don't get the 20%. So even if you're at alert level 2, okay, and you're basically at 50% and you have a safety seal of 10, that's all you get, 60%. So it's important that our mayors and our barangay captains really push hard on vaccinating so they can hit higher than 70% because the incentive is big. No, that's 20% additional in capacity.
Would you say, sir, that these 2 weeks that were given for alert level 3 be used by businesses to transition even smoothly to an alert level 2?
Yes, everybody is preparing for alert level 2. They expected it to happen, but I caution them to say that, okay, let's that's our ask, but let's expect that they will keep it on alert level 3, which they are fine. They will with a 60% in NCR, but in the other areas that are not in alert level three, but they have not hit the vaccination rate of 85%, they're just going to get 30%. Basically, an alert level 3. If they have the safety seal, that's 40%. You're not going to make much money or hardly break even at 40% capacity. It's only when you hit 60 to 80% that you will, the higher you go, of course, the more you make. And remember, November 15 onward to the new year, that's when everybody starts to shop, to eat, to spend, to celebrate. Now, we have to open the economy. We have to believe that. And look, my point is, when you're vaccinated, the chances of getting hospitalized is very minimal. So even if you have 10,000 cases, but they're all fully vaccinated, the chances of hospitalization is very small. Maybe 5% of that will be hospitalized. So I think we have to change our mindset. No, people will always get infected. Provided they're vaccinated, then they will be shielded. And let's not get scared with the numbers going up. No? The numbers are, if they're going up for the vaccinated, it's fine.
Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship, Joey Concepcion. Mr. Concepcion, thank you for joining us.